Hey guys, happy Friday. Welcome. I'm super excited to bring you guys some extra added value today. I've had a lot of you messaging me about Facebook and how to do your lives. So my question to you today is, do you have a game plan for your Facebook lives to build your business, or are you flying by the seat of your pants? No judgment here. It is Fess Up Friday and we have all done that. So as you're hopping on, I would love to know where you are watching from, what state, if you're in the States, what country, and I want to know what the weather's like there. I'm excited. It's Super Bowl Sunday. I'm in the Northern California area, so I got my Niner gear on, and I'm excited to bring you guys a lesson plan. How many of you guys would feel a lot more comfortable with your lives if you actually had a game plan? Now, I did call it Fess Up Friday because yesterday I shared why to do your Facebook Live, some statistics. If you missed that, it was awesome info that I have gathered from the community that I'm in. And when those stats were shared with me, I was mind blown. Why would you not do Facebook Lives to build your business, right? It's ridiculous if you're building online. So if you're watching this on replay, please put hashtag replay and let me know. Introduce yourself. I'd love to know a little bit more about you and your business. So my confession is the very first live that I ever did. I'm a people person, you guys. I think I could probably comfortably present, but I held my phone and I was shaking. So if you watch my first Facebook Live, it's shaking. I also have left my original lives on here. They were a couple years ago. It was turned the wrong way, so I had to turn it. I've done them in my car. I've done them, everywhere in every wrong way that you can possibly do them. Sometimes you just have to embrace the suck, lean into it, move into it, and work through it and get better, right? Because I'm still, not necessarily an expert, but I'm definitely more comfortable. Plus, lighting goes a long way. I have learned that. I used to have the light behind me. So, don't worry about what you look like, right? Like, I think I've brought that bar down quite a bit. It doesn't matter, right? If you're relating to people that you want to relate to. And for me, that was the average mama that was at home. So I just got out of spin class and threw my Niner gear on. And I'm getting ready to head out this afternoon before my afternoon gets hijacked with my son. He wants to go to the mud jumps. And so you guys should be glad I'm not doing my live after that. That might be a little messy. So how many of you have ever felt confused when you go to do your lives? Like you don't know what to say, or you don't know what to do, or you feel like you held it wrong, or the lighting was wrong, right? So how would you feel if I gave you an actual like lesson plan format, excuse me? Because guys, you have to go into it. Like you wouldn't want a teacher coming in to teach a class and give value if they didn't have a lesson plan, right? You don't want that flying by the seat of your pants. And we've got two amazing teams going to Miami for the Super Bowl. They're already there. Why are they already there? Because they are preparing. They are getting game ready. They are getting a game plan. So what is your game plan? What is your game plan for building online? If you are throwing up posts expecting someone to like miraculously like reach out to you, I mean, that probably is not going to happen. That is not building on social media. And so many people think that it's effective. And then people are not fooled. It's their company people that are commenting and liking it, right? That is not a game plan for building online. So if you didn't watch yesterday's, go back and check out why to do the lives. Hey, Tala. So yes, how would you feel if you had a game plan, right? Just like Super Bowl, you show up with the right mindset for your Facebook lives and you tell yourself that you can do this and that you need to get the message out there because it's not about you. All right, if you're new to my page, I'm Emily Smiley, and I'm super passionate about building online and helping other mamapreneurs specifically to do the same, right? You can build a massive business in your Niner gear, right? I'm proof of that. So whether you are, brand new to branding or brand new to building online, I'm here to give you value today, so I'm super excited. All right, so let's jump into it. I'm excited. I cannot take credit for this. One of my mentors, Kate, shared this with me, and it's an 8-step, I would call it the perfect live, right? Because there's no such thing as a perfect live. I actually shared a live this week after I got back from a training in LA, and y'all, I had the worst tired hangover ever. Like, I never do them in sunglasses. I did the whole live in sunglasses because I was super tired. There's no such thing as a perfect live. So you have to get past that before you start. You have to put yourself in the right mindset, even before you deal with, you know, your game plan, right? So number one, you have to know who your target audience is and what do you want them to take away, right? So just like a teacher is going to be like, what is the objective of today's lesson, right? What is it I'm bringing that's valuable that are going to make people want to watch? Because you have to know that. And you have to kind of know your call to action. Like, are you going to tell them to go to your website? Are you offering, you know, a free value? Hey, thanks for hopping on. I see you guys. I'll have to go back and go in the comments. It's not showing. Number two, what is the topic of your live, right? Put it up at the top. Somebody was sharing with me yesterday that she doesn't put the title in, and she was asking. You can always go back and re-edit that. So if you've done lives already and you didn't put like a catchy, not even a catchy, like get to the point, like what is it that you're sharing in the top part of it, you know, to make people want to listen and pop in, right? Like today, it's like, do you have a game plan for your Facebook Lives, or are you flying by the seat of your pants? Because I think that's all relatable, right? We felt like we've had both. So go back and add that topic in there. That's super important. Number three, have a catchy like post to create the conversation, right? So I want to know, have you guys done a live to where you feel like you've been prepared, or have you tried to fly by the seat of your pants? Because that's important. And I've done both, and sometimes that's okay. I used to like write it all out. Now I just have like little bullet points, and that's okay, you guys. If you're doing a live, like you guys will see, especially yesterday, I shared a lot of statistics. I don't have those memorized. That's okay. Your viewers don't expect you to either. And if you're building and you've got something to share that's valuable, you know, like today's, I'm like, okay, I didn't create this lesson plan format for Facebook Lives. I got this from someone else, and I have found it really effective, and it's helped me on my lives. Would it be helpful to you? You're turning around and you're doing the exact same thing in your marketplace. So, you know, I don't know, maybe you're in health and beauty, and you're sharing valuable information about that. And you're like, you know, three tips for, you know, keeping your makeup brushes clean, or three things to bring with you on a travel, if you're into travel, whatever it is that your niche or your market is, right? Introduce your topic first. You've got about a few seconds, right? And we've all seen those where people click in and click out and click in and click out, right? People have a short attention span, and that's okay. You want to get their attention, but you will keep the ones that really want to value it. Sometimes I want to hear what they're saying, and I'm like, ooh, 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 that sounds really good, but I'll come back later. And that's okay. So you can't take those personally when you're like, oh, people are clicking in and clicking out. You know why they're clicking in and clicking out? Because they're on your their notifications, which is awesome, because that's where you want to be. Even if they click out, even if they don't watch now, maybe they come back around to later, and that's okay. Maybe they don't watch that one, but because you're in their notifications going live all the time, they're like, oh, dang, what is she doing? What is he doing? So I'm going to go back and watch that. So introduce your topic and then yourself, right? I've seen, this drives me crazy. This is a little pet peeve, all right? I'm getting a little off topic. But don't just sit there waiting for people to hop on, waiting for people to get going. That's when I click out. Like, I know some people find that super effective if they've announced, or maybe they have a really, really, really big following. I don't know. If you're doing training, I get it. Right? I've gone live in groups and I've waited. That's fine. But all that dead air time, or like I'm watching them like take a sip, and like, I'm like, I don't want to see that. Get to the point. Right? And that's me. So I would say you only have seconds to get their attention, and you want to be engaging, right? You want to be welcoming people as they're hopping on, even if you're having a conversation with that person as they're on. Does that make sense? Let me know if that makes sense for you guys. Is that valuable? So don't be wasting that time like introducing yourself. It's not about you, right? Make it brief. Get to the point. All right. So you're engaging throughout. All right. So if someone's asking a question, sometimes I get it on Facebook. You can't always see the comments, but I always be sure to go back and, you know, get back to each of those people. And a lot of times, you guys, when people are watching it, they don't feel comfortable maybe posting it on the live, but they'll message you. I get that a lot. And that's good. That's what you want. But when you're asking those questions, even if no one is on your live or a couple of people are on or whatever it is, you're asking those questions and they're answering them in their head, even if they haven't responded back to you. So I get it. It's a little like you're like, ah, there's nobody on. Like, who am I talking to? That's okay. You still want to ask those questions so that they're answering them in their head, or they're like, dang, I don't know the answer to that. And they're going to reach out to you, right? Also, you want to tell stories, right? You want to be yourself. It doesn't have to be so informational that they don't get to know you, right? Because you want to build that relationship of know, like, and trust with you, and you are not one-dimensional, right? You are multifaceted. You have, you know, sports teams that you like. You have hobbies that you like. So it's okay, you know, to share a story. I shared, was it Monday? Like my elevator story. I was like, there has to be a Facebook Live in here somewhere, right? So use those stories in your Facebook Lives because it was hilarious. Like that was a hilarious story. And Tala, actually you were there, right? I was so like disheveled when I got off the elevator, but what? I made a live out of it. So engage your audience, right? Ask questions anyway, because their answers will come. That connection. Number six is your content. Tell stories in your content. Maybe give like a couple of tips, not very many or whatever you feel like you can get to. Number seven, what are you doing to focus on creating that connection? So I kind of already get into that, right? Yeah, that was super crazy. You'll have to watch my Monday live. Get over the hangover part. Like I'm so tired in that, but I did make a live out of it. It was awesome actually. So, you know, creating that connection is an ongoing process. It's not going to just happen with one live, which is why it's important to do more than one live, right? You want people to get to know you. How do they get to know you? By doing lives, right? And then the last thing, number eight, is you want some sort of call to action. Okay, another pet peeve. You can't say, and I've given like a soft call to action. I get it. I'm like, hey, if this was valuable, you know, please let me know, you know, that it was valuable for you or if you have any questions or, you know, but if you're interested, you need to not be so vague. Like, what is it that you want them to do? Sometimes it is as simple as like, hey, like, comment, share this with somebody if they find this, you know, important, right? So if you know someone who is struggling with Facebook Lives, maybe share this with them and see if they find it helpful. That would be a perfect call to action, right? If you are, I don't know, offering something for free, like, hey, I have 10 tips for travel, reach out to me or message me or whatever it is that you wanna say, or I'll put a link in, if you've got a link for it, where you can get my 10 tips for travel, right? Or whatever it is. Or, hey guys, my makeup tip is, whatever for spring, 5 tips for spring, or for keeping your brushes clean, whatever your topic is, you want to have some sort of call to action. If you don't have like a set up blog or whatever, it doesn't have to be like elaborate. You can just be like, hey, if you're struggling with this, message me and I'd be happy to help you. Or let me know. I'm such a teacher. I like the feedback. I'm like, hey, message me. I want to know what you're up to. Right? Like yesterday, I'm like, I want to know like what your lives are. And I did have a couple people that are like, hey, I'm struggling with this live thing. I watched the statistics that you shared and you're right. I have to work through this fear of doing lives because I've got to get in front of people. And if I'm not going to build it old school, going out and presenting and, you know, pounding the pavement and prospecting every single one around me, I'm going to have to get better at presenting myself on video. And it's not about perfection. Hello, have we met? Like, I am not perfect, but I'm getting out there, and you can do the same in your business too. You need to lead with value and you need to engage, right? Because you can't just spout, because that's not very different than buy my stuff. There has to be that relationship there, and you'll figure it out. You start to kind of figure out what your audience likes or not. I've done enough lives now where I can look back and I'm like, well, that was a bust. No one cared about that. I might have been pumped on it. And then there's another one that's like, are you stuck? Every single time I do one, like, are you stuck? I get it. I felt that way. And that was my number one problem. I'm stuck. I'm out of people. And how the heck do I build online? Those were like my three things. And so I do a lot of lives on those because it helps people. So what can you do that will help solve a problem for them? All right, quick recap. Number one, What do you want viewers to, what do you want them to do, right? What's the topic of your live? Number two, catchy post, create conversation. Introduce your topic first, then you second. Introduce yourself briefly and engage. Engage, engage, engage. Engage throughout. Number six is actually getting to your content tips. Try to throw a story in there to make it interesting because people will remember stories more, right? So like Monday's live was on like getting on the elevator. Like you have to make it happen. And how many of us can relate to that in our business? Sometimes they don't want you on the darn elevator, but you get on anyway because you're determined to make it happen. So give a few tips or whatever, engaging throughout, right? Asking questions. Number seven, what are you doing to, you know, create that connection with your audience? Are you calling out their name? Are you welcoming them? Are you asking questions? Are you relating with them? And then the last one is you want to reiterate your call to action. You have to tell people specifically what to do, right? I teach fitness classes and I can't even tell you how many times people just want to come in there like, just tell me what to do, right? It's no difference in business. So don't feel like you're being salesy or spammy if you're like, hey, this is freaking awesome. Go over to my website and check it out. There's nothing wrong with that. So you just have to allow yourself to have that call to action, right? So, you know, make some notes for your lives, but not too many because you don't want to sit there reading them, right? I've done that. That looks, how does that? That does not look right. It's not effective. You want to engage, right? You've got a few seconds to engage with people. So get their attention. Don't wait. It's annoying. Be authentically you, but be energetic. Like some people, there's a lower energy level on their lives. And it goes through. Does that make sense? It's kind of like, you know, how many of you have ever played like a music in the car? And statistics actually, studies have shown if you play like an upbeat, you actually drive a little faster. I probably drive a little happier, maybe a little crazier, I don't know. But if you're like playing like chill music, right? It like slows you down. So what energy are you bringing to your lives, right? I would say that's just like a pro tip. And to make sure that you're engaging throughout and then your call to action. All right, you guys, so I hope that you found this super helpful. Lives are important. And when you're writing a lesson plan and a format down, it takes some of that pressure off of you. You're like, okay, I have a clear understanding of what it is that I'm doing. Because you guys, if you're building online, you can't just throw crap out. You have to have like a roadmap strategy for how to build online and to make connections and relationships because that is ultimately the goal, right? It's not just to put your content out there. It's for people to relate to it and to get with you and go, I feel the same way. Please help me or, you know, whatever it is that you're sharing. That is the most important thing. There's no such thing as a perfect live. So it's not about you. You have to have your message stronger and that comes from inside. So bring your energy and bring your A game. And if you mess up or you fumble or you whatever, we've all done it. Just move on. Laugh at yourself, right? You have to not take yourself so seriously. You know, you're not going to get a professional looking, you know, Emily. I mean, it's happened, but not on the daily. So just get out there. You guys can do it. All right. So if you found this helpful, but you're like, hey, I'm stuck. I do need like an actual roadmap. Reach out to me. I'd be glad to send you a free boot camp. It's totally free. You can also head over to emilysmileylive.com. And it's on there. You just register in, put your email, and then you will get your free boot camp. In the meantime, you guys, write that content down, get clear about what it is you're sharing, connecting with people, and get on those Facebook Lives. If you're still finding yourself stuck and super scared, let me know. I'll see. I would love to hop on your live, comment, you know, get some engagement going in there, and go crush it. All right, you guys, I'm excited for this weekend, Super Bowl Sunday, but I will see you guys next week again with some more valuable content. In the meantime, get out there and crush this and go Niners. Bye, guys.